The vantage point of space is incredibly important. It's one of those invisible pieces of infrastructure upon which we all depend, and most people don't even realize it. The food we eat was grown using fertilizer that was placed using imaging from space, harvested using tractors guided by satellites and brought to our tables through ships and aircrafts that are guided by satellite.
Space really plays a very important role in how we look at solving sustainability problems on Earth. When you have years and years of data collection from satellites, you can make better decisions.
I think space has an incredibly powerful role to play. Nano satellites are these satellites, if you imagine them, about the size of a loaf of bread. Rather than having very large, kind of monolithic and exquisite satellites, we launched Spire with the mission of using these new swarms of nano satellites to really provide new data sets and new opportunities to make smarter decisions.
What Spire really cares about is taking data from space to help solve sustainability problems on Earth. When you have smaller satellites or you can have more consistent coverage around the world, then you start to have a really interconnected network that can process data rapidly and then can just accelerate the types of use cases and problem solving that you can do. There are a number of ways that space technology can be used to reduce emissions, particularly when you talk about aircraft and when you talk about shipping, which are two industries that are really involved in emissions. And this really comes from collecting data, combining it with other information, and doing analytics. And you can start to look at what routing are they taking and how do they make different decisions there that can both improve their time of arrival, but also improve their emissions and how efficient they are being at fuel consumption. You can't decide how to fix something if you're not measuring it. And so by measuring it, identifying where it's happening more than you expect, you can start to take action about it.
And so data from space and from satellites like Spire is used to help the industry to reduce their own costs and reduce their own emissions. One of the major problems that Spire supports with its satellites and with its services is fighting climate change. As just one example, GHGSAT from Canada uses sensors in space to directly detect and monitor methane and CO2 emissions. If I am an operator, for example, of a pipeline, I have a huge set of surface area that I need to monitor and detect very quickly if we have a methane leak. You need to know where emissions are happening. And so GHGSAT has the crowning achievement of detecting the largest leak ever, which was the Nord Stream leak in the North Sea. When you want to see the big picture, really the only way to do it cost effectively is from space. One of the tremendous benefits of this innovation in the industry, where satellites are getting smaller, they're getting more affordable, and launch costs are coming down, is we will get better applications and better data, get it into the hands of users faster, and we will get that collaboration between users and analyzers of the data in order to produce better applications and solve these problems.
One of the innovations of Spire Global is an innovative business model we do called Space Services.
Space as a Service, or SPAS, is for the space industry what cloud computing was for the web industry. Our vision with Space Services is that it should be as easy to deploy an application into space as it is to deploy something to the cloud. So Spire takes our customers from an idea to a operational service in space and data flowing to their customers. So that starts with us working with our customers to understand, okay, what does your end application look like once it's in space? We then will either build a customized solution, like a dedicated satellite, or in many cases, we will take a device and put it on an existing satellite that's being launched to enable it for their application. Whatever it is, we take them from an idea to an existing set of satellites in space that are gathering that type of data. And they don't need to be thinking about launches. We take care of all of that.
So examples of this sort of thing could be a customer that we work with who has a particular payload to monitor wildfires, where instead of having to build all of the satellites themselves, they can then deploy that payload on top of our infrastructure. This way, they can deploy applications to space more cost-effectively and more rapidly. Our ambition for 2030 is to really make sure that governments, that corporations, and that the average citizen really understands how important space is in what they do day to day.
There is incredible power available, incredible tools available. It's never been easier to take an idea and make it real in the space industry. We've never been able to do it as fast as we can do today. What we need more is of that collaboration so that we can move faster than our problems.
Mm-hmm.